of us last year have been getting a straight off grandma's stove. Built two fours next to each other, within a day I hit them both. Slide on the crib in Gucci socks, cause this marble floor's expensive. After you buy this rock, I'm careful, smoke that shit.
Right, everybody, we are about to, you can't see me, I'm too tall, what's happening? See me, 6'7". Sure. Welcome back to a new video. For people that follow me on Instagram, you probably think, you know, you follow someone on Instagram because you enjoy their content in some way, shape, or form, yeah? But nah, not in our generation. People that follow you actually sometimes hate you. And today, we're about to find out what you all think of me, your assumptions of me. But yeah, most of them are gonna be actually my first and honest reaction of what you said. I tried not to look at them, but I did see some of them, so unfortunately, some of them won't be, but most of them will be my first impression of what you said about me. Also, got the new shoes on, yeah, Jordans. Jordan 3s, yeah, madness. Okay, the first assumption is small legs. Look at these fucking things, yeah, boom. You understand me, yeah? How many mentioned, I actually do kind of have small legs right now. To be quite honest, I have been dealing with, like, many injuries when it comes to my legs. They used to be actually pretty big. Like, it's actually embarrassing that they were bigger than they are now. Probably pop up a picture on the screen, but yeah, they're definitely shrinking down as the days wear off, especially because I'm not training them in lockdown. Who trains legs in lockdown? If you're training legs in lockdown, you definitely just want them like teachers, pets type of guys, like fuck that. Okay, the next assumption is kisses girls with his eyes open. Wow.
Can I kiss you?
Not a fucking chance. To be honest, it probably happened maybe like once because, you know, when you're younger, you don't know what the hell you're doing. You're just there like this. You know what I'm saying? Like, probably. Maybe it happened once or twice. But I definitely do not do that, so I don't know why you assumed that of me, yeah? Alright, next assumption is... you suck moist... you suck more steroids than Chronic Hanley does Hayden's. Yeah, I say that's pretty much impossible because he's basically like a chimney, you know, but yeah, it is what it is, isn't it? It is what it is. It ties into actually the next assumption. You are a fake natty. Fake natty? Do you know what a fake natty is? Let me just clear this up, alright? Fake natty is somebody that actively claims to be natural when they're not natural.
The question was, have you juiced? We haven't. Simple as that.
Have you ever seen me claim natural in the last like a year and a half? Please, bring up a clip, yeah? I'm getting close to you because it's getting serious. Bring up a clip of me saying I'm natural in the last year and a half, yeah? And then you can call me a fake nanny, alright? Fair. Next assumption. Probably pisses in the urinal with his pants by his ankles. You know what? I'm actually too short to actually go to the urinal.
Hey, oh, pee pee time.
So when I go to the toilet, I actually have to go into the like the proper like toilet, like, you know, like the blocks, whatever they're called. Yeah, I don't know what to call them. And I actually have to sit on the toilet because I'm just too short to reach any urinal or anything like that. Next assumption is you sleep with the light on. Why are people trying to expose me? I'm not gonna lie. Yeah, that is kind of true. I do actually kind of sleep with the light on. I don't sleep with a light on, see, this is the problem, right? I sleep with my TV on.
What? Bro, what are you talking about, man?
Because I get freaked out, but if you understood what happened in my room before, right? These mad things happened in my room, what do you get onto? People are gonna say I'm some weirdo or something, but some mad shit was happening in my room. Like, I was fine, like, I was sleeping with the light off all the time. But ever since that weird stuff started happening in my room, that TV is always on. You know what, I shouldn't have made this video, it's just really exposed me. Next assumption is your willy is 1 inch long.
Is there more underneath, or is that it?
Oh, yeah, it is. If you look at it this way, look, I'm a very short man, so I maybe have short man syndrome. I wouldn't even go as far as saying it's 1 inch, probably hitting that like 0.5 mark, you know, but what can you actually do about it? Might buy one of them big long stretchers, you know, them big like as you see, like the big stretch thing, you stretch them out and make them bigger. Yeah, I might have to buy one of them, but we'll see.
I want it to hang down to my knees. They moved up my knees.
Next assumption, your arse is like a dartboard.
1, 2, 3.
Oh, wow. Wow. Don't even know what to say, to be quite honest. Yeah. Next assumption is you make money off YouTube. I wish, are you understanding me? I wish so bad that I made money on YouTube. But unfortunately, YouTube is fucked up and you have to have 1,000 subscribers. So look at big money man Ben.
Less jibber jabber.
He's after hitting the big 1K, he's gonna be making dollars, yeah. See Ben, he's a six-figure guy, get onto him, yeah. If you want a little extra change, like ask Ben, he'll give you some money. Next assumption is you're only into girls who go to the gym. Ay, wow. Nah, definitely not. I'm not one of them type of people. Like, I don't really be picky. To be fair, I am kind of choosy, like, and picky, but I wouldn't say, oh, you don't go to the gym, so you're not, like, I can't, like, talk to you and like that. Like, that's not the way I am, but it definitely does help, I will say that. Especially for someone that is competing, and I am going to be competing. It is kind of hard to understand for people that don't know anything about the gym, because when it comes to competing and when it comes to dieting and prep, it's a very selfish little game. You have to be on point every single day. You need to be doing everything for yourself, making meals for yourself, everything. Especially when you're not able to like eat out and everything, you can't really give so much time into like, if you have like a partner or something. It very much depends on like how accepting the person is. It doesn't matter if they're going to the gym, it's just how accepting they are of your lifestyle. Next assumption is you have the fattest head in the world. Whoa, I say some people have fatter heads. Vincent Kompany, he is an absolutely massive head. He definitely has a fatter head than me. But you know what, I do kind of have a fat head, especially right now because I'm bulking and my head gets really fat. Actually, I kind of backed down on calories just a tiny bit because my face is getting so fat that my cheeks are like, I don't know if you saw it in videos and pictures and shit, but like my face was so fat. Like it looked like one of them like blow of fishes. So fishes, yeah, that's just great, isn't it? Fish, yeah, fish. Next assumption is you are such a softy man. Yes, that is actually very, very true. I'm a softy, yeah. If you know me properly, if you've ever talked to me a lot when it comes to like relationships or even like when it comes to like different type of stuff like that, like deep stuff, I'm very soft. Yeah, I think people have this like wrong perception of me that I'm very like, you know, cocky and I don't give a fuck. You know, I'm just whatever, like people just have this weird perception of me, but I'm definitely not like that. I'm not like that at all. People that know me, I'm sure will vouch for me for that. Yeah, I'm not. I'm really not like that, yeah. Next assumption is harsh self-critic. Looks suck up, but soft. See, that is literally me. If you ever catch me looking in the mirror at myself, normally it's because I'm actually trying to point out something bad about myself. Like, I'm really like that. I don't know, it's always the way I've been. When I was younger, I was like proper kind of like a fat kid and everything, so I know, there's like a bit of that like kind of chubby fat kid still in me. I still kind of think like that. Next assumption is, thought you were mad stuck up, you know, but it was vice versa too. Now it's love. Yeah, 100%. I remember, this is like Keenan that said that. I remember like when it came to body part, we both kind of had this weird perception of each other. I thought Keenan was a bit stuck up. He thought I was a bit stuck up, but it's actually like the complete opposite. We're not like that at all. I think to be honest, when it comes to like social media and everything, it's very easy to kind of put off that like kind of vibe that you're stuck up and that you're cocky and like all the type of stuff. But at the end of the day, like, you are on social media, you're literally talking, like, I'm talking to a camera right now in my bloody living room, no one's around me. You kind of have to put on this little, like, it's not fake, it's not an act, but you have to, like, kind of, it's like an alter ego or something like that. A different side of you, if you get me. But yeah, I'm sure, like, some people do think me or Keenan is kind of cocky, but we're actually, like, the opposite. We're just some little anxious kids that really, like, hate ourselves. We stand in the mirror, like, looking at the mirror saying, I fucking hate you, mate, you're an ugly. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, that's just reality of it. Next assumption is, assumed you could definitely take on Gary Pineda for Carolina Body Power. If anyone knows, if anyone watched my recent Q&A, you know what happened in that situation. Yeah, it's all messed up. You know what's actually ironic in this situation? Gary is more than likely going to be my next coach. But you never know, it could be all just like a master plan. I'm just trying to get closer to Gary. And he'd be like, oh, yeah, like, there's nothing wrong with him. And I'll just go, boom, try his girl. You never know, it could be a situation now when he hasn't. Next and the last assumption of the day is, you act confident in front of the camera, but off camera, you aren't confident in yourself. Yes, I would say that is kind of true and kind of not true. As I said before, it's kind of like something that is like way better now, but it's still slightly there. You might see me like picking up a camera in like the middle of like town or something in Galway, and like I'm talking to myself, you might think, oh, look, he is confident, but trust me, I'd be shitting myself. I hate doing that. Picking up a camera in front of people is the most terrifying thing. And I will honestly say, if you suffer with social anxiety, which is something I definitely did and I'm definitely way better at now, pick up a camera and talk to yourself. Even if you don't want to put it anywhere, if you don't want to put it on YouTube, just pick up a camera and start talking to yourself. You will shit your pants. But if you keep doing it, trust me, it actually helps so much. Like, that's going to be the video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Bit of a different one, your assumptions of me. To be fair, they were actually pretty accurate. I'm definitely not a dickhead. I think that's the main thing I want to get from out of this video. Everyone that thinks I'm some cocky dickhead, yeah, that's not me. I'm not like that at all, I promise. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Leave a like, subscribe. Thank you guys for watching. I'm about to get out of this close because I basically have nowhere to go because it's obviously coronavirus and all that. But yeah, you know what I'm going to say next. We up.
Jacket, she a freak like me as well. Let lick these diamond grills. Walked in the shop, bought all that bike up. Now Sue sold that on the shelf when the T got raided. I took the rap. One of us gotta make it back. 3-2 autos fitting us whack. Anything moving's getting collapsed.